Hi, I'm Bill Wong, and today on Kit Close-Up, we're going to take a look at a pair of wireless development platforms.
All right, today we're going to be taking a look at the BeaglePlay and the complementary BeagleConnect Freedom. Let's start first with our BeaglePlay. Take a look at this. Inside we have the board itself. And because it's a wireless technology, we have some antennas that we'll take a look at a little bit later. Okay, we'll start by looking at the back of the board. This is the main processor. It's from Texas Instruments, and it's an AM6254. It has multiple ARM Cortex, including an ARM Cortex A53 processor. We'll get into those in a little more detail. The memory chips are below, and the wireless modules are here. You can flip this thing over, and you can see we have a micro SD card, which you can boot from. There is a microbus for expansion support, and for off-board support, there's a quick expansion connector for I2C, another one for the Grove format. We have a pair of CSI connectors here. There's the CSI2 for cameras. This one is for displays. If you're going to be doing debugging, you can take advantage of the JTAG, but there's no header that's actually installed in that. The battery for the real-time clock can be added onto there. Now I'll take a quick look at the input side of things. We have a USB Type-C. We can provide power and things of that nature to it if you're not powering it directly. Likewise, there's a USB Type-A connection. This header here is for UART, which can be used for debugging. And it has an HDMI output standard connector, which is quite handy. The gigabit Ethernet here is complemented by a single pair Ethernet connection. You'll notice the jacks are slightly different. There's really not a lot of standards for a single pair Ethernet at this point, as there is with the standard Ethernet. The advantage is that this can be used with other single pair Ethernet devices. So here are the antennas that I had pulled out before, and they all connect at these various spots here on the board. They provide access to Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and sub gigahertz wireless. Next, we'll take a look at the Beagle Freedom Connect. It sort of complements the Beagle Play board. And you can see that you have a module, and antenna, and a USB connection. The antenna gets applied like so. And one of the things that you'll notice is on this battery-operated device, we have a microbus connection, similar to the one that's on the BeaglePlay. And the advantage is you can now put additional sensors on here and connect them wirelessly to the BeaglePlay. This is used for debugging and for charging.
Okay, so let's take a closer look at what's inside the board. To start with, the Texas Instruments AM6251 Cetera is a system-on-chip that comes with multiple processing cores. For the main applications, you can use the quad-core Cortex A53, and for real-time support, you can use the Cortex M4F. Now, there's also two TI-specific programmable real-time units, and these are designed for very timing-critical situations. They're more like DSPs than anything else. And one of them is actually used to support time-sensitive networking, should you choose to use that on the gigabit Ethernet port. That port also is tied to a two-port switch so that the connections that are on the BeaglePlay are actually one port into the device, but actually two connections. So you could essentially daisy-chain this with different Ethernet networks if you want. On the communication side, it also has USB 2.0, the Type-C support and whatnot is more for debugging. It's not really part of the chip per se. And it does have graphics support, including the HDMI output that I mentioned earlier. The other piece to the puzzle was the BeagleConnect Freedom. And you can see this is a nice, small, compact system with the microbus support on there. And it has a Cortex M4F as well that you can actually program. It has access to the wireless support, which includes both Bluetooth low energy as well as 802.15.4, which can support things like Thread, Zigbee, Matter, and things of that nature. So it's designed to communicate with something like the BeaglePlay. And if you're going to be using something like 802.15.4, that can go up to a kilometer in terms of distance. It's great for sensor and control type applications. I sort of wanted to mention some of the expansion options. The microbus from Micro is actually on both the BeaglePlay and the BeagleConnect. It has I2C, SPI, and UART interfaces onto it. It also has additional pins that you can get analog inputs and PDLBUMs. And there's also a nice reset line because that way the systems can be synchronized. Seed Studio is the one that's providing the standard for Grove. This is an I2C based system, so you can essentially daisy chain these things. The hub that's sort of shown here, you can essentially drive it with something like the BeaglePlay, and all those additional connections are all tied together. So you can do all sorts of nifty things with this. The SparkFun Quick system is also the same kind of thing. It also uses I2C, so essentially you can daisy chain. And for most of the SparkFun boards, they actually have two connectors. So as you can see, cabling goes in one end, goes out the other end. So you don't necessarily have to use a hub or something of that nature. I did want to mention the software that runs on this system. The BeaglePlay can run Linux, and there are versions that you can easily download, put on a micro SD card, pop it in, and away you go. The standard one also essentially has a web-based interface that is based on Visual Studio Code. And this allows you to do C programming, actually any one of a number of different languages. And essentially, once you start in, boot this thing up, you can get onto the screen, start playing with your keyboard and mouse, start programming immediately. There are plenty of sample applications that are associated with it. But overall, it's a very easy system to get up and running. Overall, the BeaglePlay board and the whole family of BeagleBone systems are very easy to work with and have quite a following. One of the advantages is that those parts are generally available, as opposed to something like a Raspberry Pi, where if you are working in smaller quantities or things like that, you're going to have to use something called the Raspberry Pi compute module. The chips from TI are generally available, so you can design them directly onto your board. And the layouts for all the other BeagleBone boards like BeaglePlay are available. So you can always use that as a starting point if that happens to be something that's handy. So thanks for watching Kit Close Up, and check out our other Kit Close Up videos when you get a chance.